Do you remember the first time you heard Pearl Jam? Do you remember when you heard them play the song that told your story? I was in college and still dating my high school boyfriend. One weekend, I came home to spend time with him. Instead, I spent Friday night waiting for him to come back from being out with his friends. He finally came in around 4 in the morning and tried not to wake me up when he climbed into bed. But I wasn't sleeping. I'd been up all night, thinking that maybe what everyone told me about him was true.
Why are you so kind to me?
What? Because that's how you treat someone when...
What? What do you think is going on here? What do you think?
Am I the only girl you're seeing? Because I...
Yes.
But even though that guy was my first heartbreak, when I hear Better Man now, that's not what I'm thinking of at all. Usually when I hear it, the lyrics are being sung by thousands of fans while Pearl Jam plays the music for us. So it's not about regretting the time I wasted on that guy or reliving any pain that he caused me. It's about the relationship between the band and the people who love their music. And that's why I'll always love that song. Hi, I'm Kelly, and that was one of my Pearl Jam song stories. It's also a scene in a play I've written about 6 Pearl Jam fans that tells their story through the music of their favorite band. They're like us, people who first discovered Pearl Jam because the music really connected with us and something that was going on in our lives. And it tries to show how that music and the community that we've built around us has continued to comfort, support, and inspire us, no matter what life has thrown our way. Over their career, Pearl Jam has been through a lot, and not only have they made it through, they've done so while making fantastic music. And they've also given us hope that no matter what life throws our way, we can make it through as well. So that's what this play is about. I've tried to show how that music, our connection to the band and each other, has continued to have such a great, important place in our lives. Your specific story might be a little different than the characters on stage, but I think you'll recognize these people, these fans. They're the faithful too. I'm presenting the show on Thursday, December 5th in Seattle, the night before Pearl Jam's concert at Key Arena. I know a lot of fans will be in town, and I'm so excited I'll have the opportunity to share this play with you while you're here then too. So this campaign is to raise funds to allow me to do that. But more than that, I'm asking that you help me make this celebration of our unique community even more special by allowing the proceeds of the show itself to go to one of Pearl Jam's dearest beneficiaries, Advocacy for Patients with Chronic Illness. If we can raise the production costs here, that will allow the money we raise from tickets and memorabilia sales to go directly to this organization that means so much to so many. Below, you'll see a breakdown of what we need to make that happen, along with some thank you gifts I hope you'll really enjoy. And not only will you be helping us create this fundraiser for advocacy, through a special arrangement with Fractured Atlas. Your donation here will be tax deductible as well. In the coming weeks, we'll be posting updates and videos letting you know how the process is going. I hope you'll enjoy following along and maybe even becoming involved yourself. You are the faithful. This is your band. This is your music. This is your story. Thank you for allowing me to put it on stage. To you.